Blackstone presents The Ally by Iván Repila, epilogue by Aisha de la Cruz, translated by Mara Faye Leatham. This book is read by Thom Rivera and Frankie Corzo. Listen up. I'll tell it to you singing. Nacho Vegas. 0. I'm the most feminist guy you'll ever meet. But sure, I have my contradictions. Right now, for example, my 5 roommates and I are throwing eggs at a group of naked and semi-naked women demonstrating in front of City Hall. The first 2 flew past the mark, but the next ones make a perfect impact on the face and tits of the women holding up the main sign. I see our eggs flying in slow motion, describing a lovely arc from down to up and up to down, until they break and become sticky snot, natural and devoid of beauty. And I think about David's slingshot and the outline drawn in the air by the stone before it inflamed the flesh and separated the cartilage from Goliath's bone. And I can't help but think how right I am when I say that there's something platonic about violence.
The one with the waxed pussy is really hot, says Hugo.
I can't say exactly what the reason is for the protest, because I've been attending these kinds of events for too many weeks now, and I confuse the plots. And of course my roommates don't know either, so I don't know who or what I'm throwing eggs at. It could be my mother, or my girlfriend, or my sister. One of my grandmothers is dead. The riot police, stationed amid the demonstration and the counter-demonstration, start getting nervous when 300 grams of yolk tint a blonde woman's hair orange. But we're protected by the crowd and still have a dozen ovoid grenades in our pockets, so we stick to the plan. We won't stop until there are none left, we'd said. I'll admit throwing eggs isn't an original idea. Pathetic even when compared to other forms of urban guerrilla warfare in vogue at the time. But it's easy for me to convince the team. Eggs are cheap, easy to get and to hide, they aren't a serious enough offense to get us in real legal trouble, and above all, they represent male virility, our balls, our huevos. You don't want balls, right? Well, here are ours, I think I said. Have our huevos. The guys loved that. Especially Donovan, whose addiction to anabolic steroids has turned him into a 260-pound boy obsessed with his genitals. Calling him a boy is a private joke. He's 35 years old, but he still lives with his parents.
The one on the left with the freckles is really hot, says Hugo.
The storm of eggs has raised hackles. Some of the women confront the police and a group of men who were chastising them. Cover yourself up, you're whores. If I was your brother, where are you going with that body? In my day. The men insert any verb conjugated in the third person plural things. If I've learned anything during these months of continued exposure to the universe of feminist demonstrations, it's that whatever the protesters are demanding, they can always be upbraided for being women. That might sound grotesque, but it works. It works so well that in the face of a seemingly irreproachable demand like no more violence against women, you can hear retorts like, you must have done something, with no preamble or nuance. Not on social media, of course, where the aggressor is immediately discredited by the social masses who represent the spirit of what's right. But it works on the street, protected amid many dismayed faces, like at a soccer stadium. These kinds of events are attended by men and women of different ages, classes, and ideologies, and it's relatively easy to shout out any sort of insult. Get back in the kitchen, for example, and shortly after find a friendly face sharing a complicit smile or a wink. You know the real deal, buddy. That's how they talk. We guys can show plenty of solidarity, too.
That redhead is really hot, says Hugo.
The police have pulled out their nightsticks and people are starting to run. I look at my buddies and confirm we're out of eggs. Mission accomplished. We've come up with a powerful language of gestures to communicate any incident during the battle, so I wordlessly suggest leaving the crowd and going back to the car before we get hurt from a shift in the running mob or a billy club randomly dancing through the horde. As I quickly flee the area, where two cops are trying to separate some protesters from an older man who's raising his fist like a teenager, I see that almost...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.